whereas when he plays for his country, because there are so many other players who are at his level that can score goals, he's more or less also a provider.
Well, it's going to be a fantastic encounter, this one, boys. Sit back and enjoy it. And the rest of you at home, settle in, because it's going to be a fantastic morning of football here on SBS. On the road to Euro 2008, it's Italy against France, a repeat of the 2006 World Cup finals. We'll pause now for the national anthems, and then we'll pick up our commentator for today's match. And his name is Douglas Dean.
Coach Ramon Dominic has hardly helped matters.
And just a reminder, you can also listen to this match with Italian commentary on SBS Radio. So tune into SBS Radio in your area and enjoy this fantastic encounter live from the San Siro in Milan. OK, let's go back to our commentator now for this Euro 2008 qualifier. It's Douglas Dean. Thank you.
Inzaghi, of course, since moving on to AC Milan. No Luca Toni tonight. He has not recovered from the injury that kept him out of the last Bayern Munich game. France responding with Landro in goal, Abidal, Vieira perhaps in a centre-back role. It's been some speculation as to whether the, better known as a midfielder, of course, Vieira, whether he would move into the defence with injuries precluding the inclusion of several other players. Philip Mexès, who's been in splendid form for Roma over the last 18 months, somewhat surprisingly not included. Thuram, Malouda, Makélélé, Henri, Diarra, Ribéry, Escudé and Anelka, the remaining French lineup. It's a Slovakian referee and refereeing contingent, in actual fact. Lubos Michel is the ref, Roman Sliskot and Martin Balcott, the assistant referees, and Pavel Olziak is our fourth official tonight. Confirmation there of the Italian national side. Flash photographs all around this ground. It really is one of the most atmospheric in Italy. Without the athletics track running round, it's more like a sort of stadium you might find in England, where the fans are much closer to the pitch. The atmosphere is much more palpable. Well, Scotland won their game earlier against Lithuania, so have really put the pressure on these two bigger boys. Only two can qualify from the group of seven. Three sides have already fallen by the wayside, effectively, although of course they still have qualifying games to play: Lithuania, Georgia and the Faroe Islands. Scotland, France, Italy and the Ukraine, four sides battling for two spots. Something has to give. Italy in the all-blue, attacking the goal to your right in this first half. France in their chain strip of all white. Games between these two sides tend to be dramatic. Recent history, of course. World Cup last year, penalty shootout which the Italians took. Euro 2000, the final. Wonderful game of football in which Italy probably did enough to win. Alex Del Piero, man in the picture there, missing two gilt-head chances to put Italy 2-0 up. And how they were made to pay. A splendid French recovery. Sylvain Wiltord and David Trezeguet. Trezeguet, as he's known in Italy, already top of the list of the scorers' charts in the Italian Serie A. Not starting the match tonight, though. Oddo down the line to Camoranesi. Camoranesi trying to trick his way past Aluda. Enjoyed a bright start to his Chelsea career. Oh, that's schoolboy stuff from Massimo Oddo. Foul throw. Really don't expect to see that. Oh, we're approaching the end of the second minute, about the time that Sidney Govou gave France the lead back in September. But that benchmark has been and gone here. Henri and Elka rather chasing down after Cannavaro. Always the feeling with Anelka that he hasn't quite lived up to the potential he showed as a younger man, but he still remains a very, very fine striker, of course. Signed a new contract at Bolton in the Premier League. I'm sure they'll delight their fans, as they've enjoyed a rather, or enjoyed is maybe not the right word, a rather sticky start to the season. Here's Malouda looking to use his pace. Bit of a shirt tug there, but the referee wisely allowed it to carry on as France still retained possession. Piero as he looked to turn away from his man. Anelka was the guilty party. Enjoys a love-hate relationship, really, with the national team fans. Alex Del Piero, undoubted ability, practically godlike status for Juventus. He doesn't have a bad record at international level by any stretch of the imagination, but a lot of fans still find it hard to forgive him for those misses in the Euro 2000 final. Gattuso chasing back. I noticed during the anthem that he's got a rather fetching plaster just above his left eye. France perhaps understandably looking to take the sting out of the crowd, the sting out of the early Italian pressure. It's actually the visitors who are knocking the ball around with a little bit more confidence. Offside flag though against Anelka. There is the French coach. It was actually handball rather than offside. Could well have been both though. Pirlo, very much the Italian playmaker. Zambrotta. Italy starting to get into some sort of rhythm, albeit inside their own half. Oddo flicks the ball down the line. Camoranesi is tackled strongly from behind by Abidal. Strongly but fairly. Here's Gattuso. Onto it. Oh, it's magnificent defending by Makalele. Goodness me. 19 defenders out of 20 would have just hoofed that into the crowd, and rightly so. Such a splendid player, Chelsea man. And here's Pirlo easily avoiding Henry. First yellow card of the match. Now it's Makalele. He seemed to swing his arm at Del Piero as the Juve man sort of wrestled for possession. Itself was actually given to France for the initial foul by Del Piero, and they've wasted it. Two French players colliding there, there could be trouble. Camoranesi not able to smuggle the ball down the line, though. He's got another chance, the wingman. Never really had the ball under full control, Camoranesi. And there's another scuffle. Vieira and Gattuso. Well, there's going to be no quarter asked and no quarter given between those two. Plays his home games in this stadium, of course. Vieira for Inter Milan. Gattuso for AC Milan. End result, though. It's an Italian throw. Inzaghi will be one of the targets if the ball can come across. That's good play by Oddo. He eventually ran out of space, though. Makalele was strong. And Landro, the PSG keeper. A long clearance downfield towards Thierry Henry, transferred in the summer, of course, from Arsenal to Barcelona. Star-studded lineup Barcelona can boast. I wonder if it will be enough to bring them success this season. There's Del Piero. Back in Serie A with Juventus after their purgatory in Serie B following the Calciopoli scandal. Here's Gattuso, actually starting to move the ball around a little bit more fluidly. Here's De Rossi. Been in good form for Roma, rather, in the opening stages of the season. Zambrotta, fetching yellow boots, looks to go past his man. Well, he wanted a foul, but the referee didn't agree. Battling back for the ball, Ribéry has lost it. De Rossi has gone to ground. Well, it could be another physical encounter at times for Mr. Michel to try and deal with. Henri, little layoff, Malouda. Italians back in numbers, but here's Henri, does well to find Malouda. Goes for goal. Well, I thought he'd gone for goal initially, as the ball curved rather dramatically towards the end. The player the benefit of the doubt, maybe he was looking for Anelka. Ambitious pass, but Anelka's quick, going to capitalise on anything if the Italian defence do hesitate. There's Vieira, subject of a bit of debate between his club coach Roberto Mancini of Inter Milan and the national coach of France, Raymond Domenech. Mancini feels that Vieira is not fully fit and shouldn't be playing. He didn't play in Inter Milan's last game last weekend against Empoli. Domenech says that's nonsense, he's nothing wrong with him, and he's playing. Zambrotta doing well to shrug off Ribéry as the Bayern Munich man looked to go past him on the outside. Here's Pirlo, always seems to have time on the ball, doesn't he, Pirlo? He's not the quickest player, but he rarely gets caught in possession. Vieira that time, though, stronger in the air. Here's Henri. And the offside flag is up. Clever pass from Henri, but Anelka perhaps just straying beyond the last defender. As an actual fact, you can see it's marginal. Marginal, but nevertheless correct. Daniele De Rossi spreads it wide to Oddo. Or at least tries to. Abidal was up and up well. Off the ball, but I think Abidal was just bigger and stronger. Here's Pirlo. And he goes to ground as Henri clips it. Contact was probably minimal, but as Pirlo was into his stride, it may well have been enough just to bring him down. Free kick for the hosts. Zambrotta getting the ball rather caught under his feet there, and he was taken from him by Diarra. Anelka having the same problem at the other end, never really managing to get the ball under control, and Zambrotta takes it for him. It's a poor clearance, though. Gives possession straight back to the French. Makalele probing for an opening. Ribéry. Italians back in numbers, as you might expect, against this powerful attacking lineup that the French have selected. Here's Vieira. French fans in the stadium shouting Olé every time the ball is passed, and the Italians responding with a chorus of whistles and jeers. Must be getting a little bit nervous. That's a lovely play. Del Piero booting it downfield towards Pippo Inzaghi. And he's won the free kick, Inzaghi, I think. Ball was hanging in the air a long time. He's obviously being fouled by the defender as he waited for it to come down. It's Del Piero. Ran outside of it, Zambrotta, but it was a poor attempt to find him in truth. Rather played it without looking. Barzagli, lovely control. Chance on here if Del Piero can get the ball across, but it touched a French player last and goes for the little more conservative option there. Del Piero accepts the corner rather than risking the first time cross on his left foot, probably aware that he only had Inzaghi for support at that stage. Huge cheer for Andrea Pirlo, who of course plays here for the European champions Milan. In it comes, it's deep to the far post! And it's scrambled away. Cannavaro it was, the Italian captain. It was Messi. Lost his footing as he came in and then with his backside on the ground tried stabbing it goalwards. Landro got enough on it. Goes behind for another corner. Second in quick succession for the Italians. Another deep one. Fouling going on at the back post by Cannavaro. Missing his regular partner, Marco Materazzi, who is injured and will be until Christmas. It's going to be difficult for Cannavaro to smuggle that ball home. A number of white shirts there were between him and the goal, but he did well. Vieira spreading it wide, Inzaghi's on the ground. Play continues, Henri taking on Gattuso. Henri shrugging Gattuso off, but unfairly, says the referee. The players continued quickly, Camoranesi. For the third or fourth time already in these opening exchanges, caught in possession. Just looks a little bit slow, Camoranesi, to me. Compare him to Ribéry or Malouda, two French wingers, both of whom have considerable pace. That's lovely play. And Gattuso charging through, and may well be the second name in the book. Inter versus AC Milan again there. Mentioned that earlier in the match. And again, not too sure how much contact there was. Enough for the referee to deem it a free kick, though, and probably rightly so, if only for the nature of the challenge, which was late on Vieira. Chance here. Well, he rather snatched at it in the end. It was good play down the right, particularly by Ribéry. Sort of toe poked it into the area dangerously. And Anelka's first touch was good, his second touch wasn't. Malouda easily avoiding Camoranesi, although running out of space in the end. Here's Pirlo. Pirlo going over the top towards Inzaghi. And Scuda gets some sort of a touch on it, but sends the ball up rather than away. Italians battling and regaining possession. Here's Oddo. They don't have much height up front, Italy. Del Piero and Inzaghi are always going to struggle for balls over the top. Ball given. And the Italians will have another free kick. Trying to prod the ball through to Camoranesi. That's good play, though. Pirlo, before that, had waited for a free kick, which didn't come, and Oddo did very well to play the ball off Abidal and win his country a corner. Good determination from the AC Milan right back. Pirlo, this time it's near post! Well, no one could get a decisive touch for Italy. And I think it was Touran. A good flick on by Camoranesi. It went towards Inzaghi. Fourth Italian corner, again near post. This time was easily cleared. Italy carry on, though. Here's Anelka. Playing the ball inside. France looking to break. Have plenty of pace available to them if they do choose to break quickly as well. Played it rather more conservatively, though. That's possibly the more sensible option at this time, as Italy, in the last 5 or 6 minutes, are just starting to get into the ascendancy. Here's Henri, miscontrols the ball. That's a collector's item. We won't see that very often. Idea from Del Piero, because he'd spotted the run of Inzaghi. The attempt to find his former Juventus teammate was rather weak, in truth. Ribéry, who's been in sparkling form for Bayern Munich in these early stages of the season. The French have massive hopes for him, of course. An enormously gifted player. I'd like to see him play more centrally, to be honest. He's always going to be a little bit more peripheral if he's out wide. There he is. This has gone around as France play keep ball. Touran slips as he plays it forward, but it still finds its target. Henri, though, penalised. Little shove into the back of Cannavaro. They'll be in opposition, of course, a couple of times at least over the course of this season. Real Madrid versus Barcelona. Ribéry turns away from Del Piero. Vieira. Ribéry again. Coming inside. Pressured by Gattuso, it's forced to going backwards. Here's Ribéry, it's a smart turn. Got a man out wide, it's Diarra. Couple of men in the box to aim for if the cross can come here. Here's Ribéry again. Diarra spreads it slightly. Probing around, the French looking comfortable in possession. The crowd getting a little bit nervous. As the visitors take control back again. That's a nice play, though, by Oddo. Stepped in front of Henri. Counter-attack is on. Here's Inzaghi. Plays it down the line towards Oddo. Touran had read it. It's not what the Italians will want, though. They won't want to be deep in their own half and having to be restricted to counter-attacks. They really do need to try and get the 3 points here. And it was needless as well. Absolutely needless. A little bit lucky, he didn't Referee didn't pull out a yellow card for that one. Cannavaro's not happy about something, clearly. Gigi Buffon did the goal kick for Italy. Del Piero being fouled as he played the pass, but the referee allows the advantage, and rightly so. Just joining us, 0-0 here between Italy and France in this Euro 2008 qualifying game from Milan. No clear-cut openings for either side. That's Camoranesi, tries to make room for a cross, wins the throw-in. Italy perhaps with a half chance for Fabio Cannavaro from a corner. France with one half chance likewise. Shot on the turn by Nicolas Anelka, which he dragged wide. Very tactical game, very interesting game tactically as well. Camoranesi does well to get the ball in. The French have smuggled it away somehow, but Italy will be able to keep the pressure on with a throw. Camera pans down the Italy bench. France overall looking a little bit more fluid in possession, but certainly not dominating. Here's Ribéry, who's starting to look quite dangerous in these last 7 or 8 minutes, playing these little give and goes that he likes to do. Here's Malouda, hasn't been in the game as much as he would like. Ribéry again, spreading it wide. Anelka. They're attacking players, France are so versatile, they can all switch to wings. Good on both feet. Cross comes in. Only one man to aim for, but he's found it. Gattuso winning out over Malouda. And winning the free kick off Malouda. Get something on the ball there, Malouda. I'm not sure that was a foul, but nevertheless, the referee saw it otherwise. Camoranesi slips as the ball to him deceives him. Italy still retained possession though as it went through to Inzaghi, who did well. Here's Pirlo. Van Brotten a little bit of space wide. Looking for the 1-2 and gets the 1-2. Cuts back in well. Is he fouled? No, says the referee. Ribéry faced by De Rossi. For the first time, France looking long towards Anelka. Not for the first time, the Italians back doubling up on him. Seeing off the danger. Milan, the Italian national team, over 60 caps, played in 2 World Cup tournaments. France coach Domenech is also a former international player, albeit a much more modest one, just 8 caps for France in the mid-70s. More modest career as well as a player. Camoranesi bringing an awkward ball down quite well, but Vieira snapped back at him and wins possession back for his country. Here's Ribéry losing control of the ball. Vieira snapping in again at Camoranesi, winning the ball fair and square. Italian fans don't like it. Here's Oddo trying to find a way past Abidal, but there was no way past. He did very well, the French player there. Referee letting a lot go. Italian fans whistling because they're not used to seeing that, of course. The Italian Serie A is noted for the number of free kicks that get awarded. This referee a little bit more tolerant than most of the top-level Italian refs, who probably would have given 3 or 4 free kicks in the last few minutes for some of the tackles that have been coming in. I think that Rubos Michel is doing very, very well. Here's Omri. Did he give Barzagli a shove? Players were late hearing the whistle, but that would appear to be the judgment. And the ball searching out Inzaghi. Trouble for Italy, of course, is that neither Inzaghi or Del Piero, their two strikers, has much of a physical presence. Well, on that occasion, the referee perhaps should have allowed the advantage to continue, as Diarra had cut inside with the ball. He's brought it back for the free kick and for the foul on Thierry Henry. I wonder in the second half if things don't improve for Italy, whether we might see Iaquinta or even Cristiano Lucarelli, just to provide a bit more of a target up there. Here's Del Piero, though. Ball into feet is going to be much more dangerous for the French to deal with. Del Piero shapes and has it taken off his toes by Vieira, who certainly is making a nonsense of claims by his club coach Roberto Mancini that he shouldn't be playing because he's not fit. And Gattuso finds himself in the book. And you can see there the referee clearly indicating that's your third one, Sunshine. Cumulative effect. Probably wasn't a booking challenge individually, but he has made 3 or 4 strong ones. And that was clumsy. De Rossi. Del Piero, smart turn. That's good play by Alex Del Piero as a shooting opportunity. It was a long way out and he hesitated fatally, Gattuso, and it was on his weaker left foot as well. Here's Ribéry looking to take on De Rossi, not able to do so, and Ribéry fouls it. Today in this same group, Scotland left it a little bit late, but did enough to see off Lithuania 3-1. And the Ukraine, who still harbour hopes of qualifying themselves, conceded the last minute equaliser. Is there to be a goal here for Alex Del Piero? Well, he never really connected with it. Did well to get into the position. Looked to be losing his balance as the ball found its way to him, though. And he drove it near post. And Landro was equal to it. Mentioned the Ukraine. Georgia. They conceded the last minute equaliser. 2 points, that's cost them. Could be fatal. It's Alzaghi off the bar. And that's twice in quick succession the Italians have breached the French defence. In fairness, I think Inzaghi was just trying to hook it across the area. Seemed to me a missed kick. And it almost fooled Dandro. Clipped the top of the bar. That will give the Italians plenty of heart. As overall, the French have probably been the better side. Certainly they've been the more composed side in possession. Pirlo, Italy pushing forward again. Here's Zambrotta, needs to get a little bit more forward. Good cross in though. Pirlo, De Rossi, smart play from De Rossi, but Zambrotta hadn't read it. It was rather static. De Rossi played the ball into the area where the Barcelona fullback probably should have been moving. Pirlo again. Camoranesi with the flick, a little unnecessary. Didn't achieve its objective either. Here's Zambrotta again. De Rossi. That's not his play. Pirlo created a lovely angle for Gattuso. Rossi jumping in rather at Ribéry, who does very well to bring the ball down, but Rossi gets back at him. Del Piero winning the ball away from Diarra. Well, Diarra surely took that out of play, but the assistant referee hasn't spotted it, and the French carry on. Ooh, Gattuso was a little lucky there. You can just see as he came charging in at Vieira, he held himself up slightly. De Rossi indicating he's taken a bit of a blow in the face. Possibly, but inadvertent. Vieira was stumbling. Arm was out. Vieira. Skewering that off as he looked for Ribéry. Pirlo helps it on first time. Gattuso is having a good match. Really are a lovely combination in the middle of the midfield there for Italy and for AC Milan, Gattuso and Pirlo. Play allowed to continue. Current situation in this group is that Scotland are top with 18 points on goal difference. France also have 18, although they've played a game less, and they won't have done by the end of this evening. So France would go top again if they can get a draw or a win here. And Italy would go top if they win, as they are currently on 16 points. Like France, they've played 7. Ukraine have played 7 as well, and they're back on 13 points. They really needed those 2 points today against Georgia. Put themselves under a lot of pressure. Potentially big game on Wednesday, though. Big round of matches on Wednesday in all of the qualifying groups. This group more than most, even. France playing Scotland. And Ukraine taking on Italy. Del Piero spreads it wide to Zambrotta. Looking for the 1-2 again. Del Piero does well to play in Barcelona now. Cross on the run, though, was overhit. It was a good break from the Italians, and they are just in the last 5 or 6 minutes starting to get into the ascendancy. They've managed to get Pirlo into the game, and when Pirlo gets into the game, Italy play. It's as simple as that. Diarra. Prompting from the side, Roberto Donadoni. Here's Vieira. Rather aimless long ball that time, though. Pirlo again, Del Piero. France throw, right down in their own corner. Somebody who a lot of people are surprised isn't on the field, Philippe Mexès. He's been developing over the last, certainly 18 months, into one of Europe's finest centre-backs for Roma. But has never quite managed to consistently impress the French coaches. Fouled by Cannavaro, who tried to sneak round the right-hand side of the big French striker to nick the ball off him and failed to do so. Just over 5 minutes until the end of the first half. It's been an interesting first half tactically rather than a thrilling first half, it must be said, but as we come into these last 5 minutes, Italy have just started to get themselves on top. A couple of decent chances. One for Del Piero, which he drove at the keeper. And Inzaghi clipped the bar, albeit with a slightly mishit shot, I think. And the French have forced a corner. Nicolas Anelka, who had their only half chance so far. Smart first touch. 14 yards out, but a rather weak, scuffed shot. And they will be dangerous on this, however. Malouda hits a very mean dead ball. And the French have plenty of physical presence and plenty of height. And Mr. Michel having a word with a couple of the players about pushing and shoving before the corner is taken. Diarra. Malouda, whose first corner was weak, he gets another chance and he's blocked out of it. Lovely turn from Ribéry on the left foot. Well, in the end it flew wide, but it was a glimpse of what he can do. Lovely control from the throw-in, look at that, took two men out of the game. Drifts across to Gattuso. Skewers the shot well wide, but it was a warning across Italy's bows. Del Piero losing control of the ball. Vieira, lovely ball. Omri, who hasn't been in the game much in truth, is Ribéry. Doesn't really need to be in the game much, though, does he, Thierry Henry? Still has a habit of popping up with goals or producing something spectacular that creates a goal for a teammate. Escudé. Abidal, elegantly brought down. Played the ball rather behind Malouda, though. The French number seven has the speed to get hold of it, though. Zambrotta with the chest off. Here's Del Piero. Italy on the break. De Rossi, though, rather casually gives the ball away. Do need a little bit more speed on the counter-attack, the Italians. Camoranesi and Del Piero playing wide, neither of them the quickest. Del Piero used to have a very sharp turn of speed, but he's lost that down the years. Plenty of craft on the ball, of course, but not quite the devastating acceleration of old. Shot comes in and Buffon gathers. Game building up nicely towards the end of the first half. It took its time to get going. Layoff by Anelka, hit well by Malouda, directly at Gigi Buffon. the half volley, caught it very nicely, didn't he? Ondo trying to turn inside towards goal, having to settle for the throw-in. Had a reasonable match down the right-hand side. It's an interesting battle between him and Abidal. Gattuso accepts the corner. No, he doesn't. Seemed to play the ball against the French defender. Assistant referee saw it otherwise. Temporarily. Anelka rather made a back for the Milan right back. He landed quite heavily, it must be said. Players taking on water, it's a warm evening. Jump for the ball. I wonder what he's thinking right now, Donadoni. He'll be pleased overall, I think. In Italy has created a couple of decent half of chances. Pirlo and Gattuso in midfield are starting to just get control of that central area. But he'll be very concerned about French pace and their individual ability, as we saw a few minutes ago with Ribéry. Took three men out of the game and then fired wide, fired well wide in truth, but the movement leading up to it was superb. Malouda just driving a half volley at Buffon as well. Very, very dangerous customers, the French. Rodot's not looking good for him. He was shaking his head and waggling his finger to the medical team down on the touchline here. Players continued, apparently with a minute to add on, although he seemed to have stopped for more than a minute for Oddo there. There's been a couple of other short stoppages as well, so we might find that we get a little bit more than the minute indicated. Camera focuses in on Luca Toni. If he were fit, of course, he would be out there for the blue shirts of Italy. Well, the minute is pretty much bang on. Slovakian referee blows the whistle to end the first half. And these two great footballing nations are level pegging here in Milan. France on top without really dominating in the first half of the first half. Italy gradually coming into their own in the second half of the first half, creating a couple of chances. The closest we came to a goal was when Pippo Inzaghi's attempted cross, I think, skewered away from his left foot and clipped the top of the French crossbar. Half-time score here at the San Siro. It's Italy 0, France 0. I hope you'll join us for the second half.
Renzi anyway, personally. I just think a nation like Italy, you know, you've got Totti, who's an exceptional talent. Where's the next Totti coming through? He's retired. Del Piero's been brilliant for a decade. He's not having a great match tonight. I wouldn't be surprised to see him go off. But then who are you going to bring through? You know, who's coming through there? The one I do know of is this Rosina, who is in the under-21 side. It won't be too long before he's brought into the squad, and arguably probably should have him in the squad anyway. But, you know, where's the creative talent to come on? We talked about Ribéry. He does have that ability. And, of course, they've got this 20-year-old Nasri. You know, the next generation also coming through, the Marseille kid, who in 3-4 years' time will be playing in Le Bleu. So it's a real issue for me.
Well, Italy, there's one of their star strikers missing, Luca Toni, now with Bayern Munich, and off to a good start in the German Bundesliga as well since moving in the summer from Fiorentina, but unavailable today through injury. And you might have caught a glimpse of, you know, Raymond Domenech throughout that first half, also up in the stands after, you know, speaking out against Italian football and saying something controversial in the lead-up to this match. He's serving a one-match touchline ban. So he is up there guiding things on remote control, if you like, tonight. But France, despite coming under pressure at various times in the first half, are still looking good for a point which would do them the world of good, you'd have to say, in their campaign to qualify. And a point will be enough to go to the top of the section. We're set now for the second half. Let's go back to our commentator, Douglas Dean.
Ukraine lost a little bit of ground earlier today when they were held away to Georgia. But Scotland maintained their excellent start to the qualifying campaign with their sixth win in eight games, seeing off Lithuania by 3-1. Italy in particular will want the 3 points here tonight because they travel on Wednesday to the Ukraine for what will be a very, very tough game. France play host to Scotland, looking for revenge. Scots, of course, beat France earlier in the qualifying campaign, 1-0. First half was notable more as a chess match for long periods rather than a thrilling encounter. Certainly fascinating matchups all over the field. Fine individual performances as well. It'll be interesting to see what the two coaches have done at half-time, perhaps with a review to switching tactics or thinking about introducing a few subs. Had no official confirmation of subs thus far. Just looking around the field, the 22 that started the match appear to be the 22 that have come out for this second 45 minutes of the long ball searching out. That's a dangerous back header. Oh, Cannavaro it was, who almost sold Buffon short with the back header. Anelka's pace proving a thorn in the side. Del Piero and Zambrotta linking up, as they did a couple of times in the first half, to good effect. Lovely flick on by Pirlo. Here's Del Piero. Forced backwards by the presence of a defender. Zambrotta does well to find Del Piero again. Zambrotta looks for the charge down the flank. And he succeeds in carrying the ball out of play. Here's Diarra. Anelka penalised for the foul on Cannavaro. Using his body illegally, the Bolton striker. Gattuso booked in the first half for a rather clumsy challenge. Has to watch his step in the second half, but knowing the sort of player he is, he rarely lets it affect his game. Such a competitive nature. Plenty of what the Italians refer to as grinta, fighting spirit. Italian crowd finding their voice. They were unusually quiet for long periods in the first half, it must be said. French did well overall in that first 45 minutes, played some nice possession football, didn't create too many opportunities, but kept the ball for long enough periods, took the sting out of a lot of the Italian attacks that way. And Zambrotta making a nuisance of himself. Has he earned the corner? Yes, he has. Did very well. Outnumbered. Managed to stretch a long leg out. Got a left foot to the ball. And earn his team this corner. Andrea Pirlo with it. It's deep again. Someone's up at the back. A crowd of players. Might have been Barzagli. There's Malouda. The ball on towards Omri. Omri's got some space to move into. He was very quiet in the first half, but that's often when he's at his most dangerous. That's unlucky. Try to slide Rule, pass it through to Riabedi. Pirlo. Italians looking noticeably a yard quicker in this second half. A little bit lackadaisical at times with their passing, with the exception of Pirlo. French look to have a little yard of space, yard of pace as well over their transalpine cousins. Del Piero does well to nip in, but then loses control of the ball. Pirlo. Cameronese with a shooting opportunity, perhaps. Goes for goal! Good save. The roars echo around the stadium now Thought he'd taken a touch too many, but he actually did very well, Camel Renese. He got plenty of power on the effort. Straight at Landropera. Renese, another deep one. It's obviously a tactic they feel is going to be useful against this French defence. Pirlo did very well in the first half, took a couple of deep ones and then slung one in at the near post, which created havoc. Del Piero this time, different corner taker. It's a near post one and it's headed away. Here's Zambrotta crossing space. Puts plenty of curl on it, but gets it a little bit too far beyond Pippo Inzaghi. See a replay of the shot from Camoranesi. Landro going up with both fists, getting enough on it to divert it over the crossbar. French just looking a little bit jittery in defence. That's two or three times already in this second half. They've either given away possession or looked like they might. Ribéry, well, he was allowed to continue for a couple of steps. And then the referee pulled him back. Wasn't quite shoulder to shoulder with Zambrotta there, was it? More Ribéry's shoulder into Zambrotta's back. Here's Pirlo with the layoff. Arcing pass from De Rossi, wide to Oddo, who slings in a lovely cross. Inzaghi had just stepped away from his marker, as he so slyly does. Cross just eluded him, though. Well, they were the better side in the second half of the second half, Italy. And they're certainly the better side in these opening exchanges of the second. Here's Henri, here's Anelka taking the ball in his stride into the area. Brilliant save. And that's the risk, of course, as Italy throw an extra man or two forward to try and break down the French defence. They leave themselves vulnerable on the counter-attack, and the French have pace aplenty. And skill aplenty as well. Henri and Anelka almost combining there. Here's Ribéry. Defender slides in, it's Barzagli, he does very well. Actually wins the throw-in as well, the ball came off the Frenchman last. Here's Oddo. Gattuso. Was he fouled? Yes, says the referee, by Makaleli. Two players who were both booked in the first half. Makaleli for a rather clumsy throwing of the arm at Alex Del Piero. Lovely play by Anelka. Used his pace and power to good effect. Just couldn't quite toe-poke it past Buffon. Abidal, Makaleli. Cannavaro beats Henri, Anelka rather, in the air. Camoranesi. Vieira with the tackle, but the ball Drake breaks to Pirlo. Lovely ball inside, Inzaghi. First touch wasn't a good one, and he was outnumbered. Good tackling back, though, by the Italians. They really have got the bit between their teeth in these opening 8 or 9 minutes. Here's Ribéry on the break. Henri plays it out wide. Diarra, who's not the slowest either. Ribéry, that's magnificent football from the French. Cuts it back. And who else was there but Fabio Cannavaro? And the game now really is starting to open up. Pirlo attempts the diagonal crossfield pass, which doesn't come off. Now you sense a goal will come. First half was very cagey, the second half. Roberto Donadoni has obviously said to his Italian charges, we've got to try and win this game. We can't be sure of going to the Ukraine on Wednesday and picking up all 3 points. They're a very tough side at home. Scotland won again today. France at home to Scotland. You would expect the French to win on Wednesday. we have got to try for the 3 points here. But at this level, of course, against this standard of player, the more you risk going forward, the greater the risk of conceding defensively. And in the meantime, the referee's been having a word with one of the French players. And Italy are preparing a change. Simone Perrotta, Roma midfielder, possibly for his club teammate De Rossi. We'll just have a look. Ribéry with the cutback, almost finding Henri. Cannavaro read it like a book, right? De Rossi, who has been a little below par, it must be said, hasn't been the force he usually is in the red shirt of Roma. Foul by Henri. Picks up a booking as well for it. Vieira again snapping in. Good game. Barrel-chested. Fabio Cannavaro doing marvellously well. Plays the ball away. Pirlo. Here's Camoranesi. Ball got caught under his feet temporarily, but he manages to work it out wide. Here's Del Piero. There's two against one on the fullback here. If Del Piero can find Zambrotta with a perceptive pass, he can't. Diarra read it, and read it very well. Anywhere will do. Patrick Vieira under that circumstance. Henri going up and doing well to get ahead on the ball, but dropped down to Massimo Bonta, former Lazio player. Now plays here, of course, for AC Milan. As does this man for Inter Milan. Vieira beating De Rossi to it. And then not beating Gattuso to it, or at least beating Gattuso to it illegally. Look at Gattuso's face. Can't believe it, can he? And it was a handball, I think, there by Vieira as the ball bobbled around. There indeed is the change. Well, Gattuso's been booked, so he's running a little bit of a risk in this second half, but I can't imagine he'll take off Gattuso. Camoranesi coming off. Fitted in and out of the match, Camoranesi. I've never quite thought he has the extra dash of verve or pace to be a genuine threat at international level against the very top teams, the way that Ribéry and Malouda are for France. But he hasn't had a bad game, in fairness. Drove a fine shot in at the start of the second half, which Landreau did well to tip over. Official confirmation on the tannoy of the Italian substitution. And the play continued as the cameraman focuses on Gennaro Gattuso, who seems to have taken a blow to the face. Ball is kicked out. Suggesting it was an elbow. Possibly taken a smack to the tooth or cut his lip. Let's have a look at the incident. Well, it's inadvertent, isn't it? It's Thierry Henry as Henry plays the header back and Gattuso tries to get the other side of him. He just runs into Henry's arm. Damage and Gattuso is back on. Ball eludes attacker and defender there. Ribéry with the flick, Henri with the flick. Ribéry's inside and Ribéry's offside. Italians keen to get things moving as quickly as possible. was it Anelka who was offside rather than Ribéry? Del Piero spreads it wide. Massimo Oddo. De Rossi. Gattuso finds Pirlo. Shooting opportunity which the crowd urged him to take. Here's Del Piero. Tries to work the angle for that famous Del Piero curler into the top corner, as he's done so many times down the years, but the French were alive to it. Didn't give him the opportunity. And now the French break again. Here's Henri. Not breaking at full speed, though, it must be said, and the Italians got plenty of players back. French would be happier with the draw than the Italians, one suspects. Although they're certainly not playing for a draw. Ostensibly the French, they are coming forward when they get the opportunity, and they're trying to take the sting out of the situation by playing good possession football. Here's Ribéry. Italians wanted a foul which didn't come. Ribéry shapes for a shot. Deflected away. Pirlo brings it down effortlessly. Turns away from Ribéry. A little bit more pace up front, don't they, Italy? Inzaghi chases away into the corner. He's got Abidal for company. He needs support, Inzaghi. He's not the sort of player who's going to beat defenders individually. Didn't get that support, and the French come away with the ball. And Anelka does very well. Uses his body strength. Luda and Gattuso sharing a joke. That's handball by the Milan midfielder as he fell over. Took possession away from the Frenchman by punching the ball off. Escobar. Long looking for Anelka. Anelka gets the flick on, but Cannavaro had sat back behind him. They've done well, France, because Italy started like a whirlwind in this second half, and they've taken the sting out initially. And they've created a couple of dangerous opportunities on the counter-attack themselves. Pirlo sliding in and sliding into good effect. De Rossi forced backwards. With a little bit of space to move into. Pirlo, there's two against one again on the fullback. Pirlo with the pass inside, Zambrotta goes down. Fans appeal. In fairness, the players don't really, and the referee continues. Malouda does well to bring an awkward ball under control. Thierry Henry will have happy memories of this stadium. Played a significant role when Arsenal came here against Inter Milan in the Champions League game and ran riot. One of the best team performances I've seen in the Champions League that night. And he was unplayable, Henry. Here's Oddo looking to be unplayable, but Abidal has got the measure of him and has had the measure of him most of the match, in fairness. And there's the French coach, banished to the stands after claiming in the build-up to the match that Italians are cheats and referees always favour Italian national teams, that they get penalties they shouldn't get, decisions in their favour they shouldn't get. UEFA understandably not best pleased with him. And the Italians not best pleased with him either. Change which the crowd don't like, because it's the local hero Pippo Inzaghi coming off. Clips the bar with an effort towards the end of the first half. Generous applause though for the more muscular figure. Less mobile figure, it must be said. But more muscular, more imposing figure of Cristiano Lucarelli, who transferred in the close season to Shakhtar Donetsk from Livorno. Here's Del Piero looking to play Lucarelli through straight away. Italy's second change. Zambrotta. Lucarelli chasing down, forcing Abidal into a rather hurried clearance, which has gone for a throw. Gattuso. Italy applying the pressure. Pirlo. Delicately lofted in. There's an offside flag. Sides have considerable recent history, of course, in big international tournaments. France knocked Italy out of the 1986 World Cup by 2-0 at the second round stage. They also knocked them out the quarter-final stage of the 1994 World Cup on their way to winning that tournament. Zambrotta, in the meantime, has gone down. Inside Diarra, rather cynically, just standing his ground and then backing his heel out to trip the Barcelona fullback. Pirlo with the free kick. Now this is potentially dangerous. If Pirlo gets this right, this could be a headache for the French defence. In it goes. It looks too deep. It is too deep. Disappointed-looking Pippo Inzaghi. But in truth, Italy do need a little bit more of a physical presence up there. They would normally have had it, of course, from Luca Toni. He's not fit. And Roberto Donadoni deciding that Cristiano Lucarelli should be given a run-out. Prolific goal scorer throughout his career, Lucarelli, but he's generally played for what the Italians refer to as provincial sides. Never made it to one of the big boys. Fell out with Livorno big time last season after the fans accused the players of throwing a match. Although if you'd seen that match, you would understand the fans' frustration. Livorno simply didn't play. Lucarelli, though, who's a fiercely committed man politically as well as on the football field, disgusted at having his honesty questioned, made it clear that he wouldn't be staying. And he was true to his word. Here's De Rossi. Modo quickly closed down. Gattuso with the chest off De Rossi. Looking to get things moving a little bit quicker, but Abidal read it. Malouda, angled pass looking for Omri, who hangs back dangerously. Omri. Ribéry comes in, and he couldn't quite find Omri with the pass. Really is a handful, Thierry Omri. Even when he's not at his best, which he hasn't been so far this evening, it must be said. Here's Del Piero. The crowd urging him to cut inside. Del Piero couldn't make up his mind. Whistle starting to echo around the stadium now, and I don't think it's because France have got the ball. Growing feeling in Italy that Alex Del Piero probably is no longer worth a place in the national squad, but retains it because he plays for Juventus, who are still the most powerful club in Italy. Not sure that's entirely fair, particularly as Del Piero has a reasonable record at international level. Fans of both Inter and AC Milan probably a little slighted, but he's still on the field. Anyway, here's Zambrotta. They won't be slighted if he scores a fantastic free kick from 25 yards out to win them the game, will they? Diarra, anywhere will do. Cannavaro takes charge. Pirlo, oh, caught in possession there, Pirlot. He was fouled by Malouda. Chelsea man just trying to get the wrong side of him. Sensed that Pirlo's first touch for once had let him down. Makalele. Ribéry, who started the match on the right-hand side, but in the second half has obviously been given free rein to roam. It's popped up on the left now. Now drifting back to centre. Thuram. Marvellous player Thuram has been down the years. Really has. One of three French survivors from the Euro 2000 final. And France came from behind to beat Italy 2-1 with the golden goal. Vieira and Henri, the other two, on the field, although there are a couple on the bench as well, notably Trezeguet, who scored the winning goal that night, of course. Italy have two survivors on the field currently, Cannavaro and Alex Del Piero. Here's Abidal, looking for the run of Anelka. Otto had read it well, though. These two sides are very evenly matched. It's going to be very tough to pick a winner. Italy, perhaps on the basis of their second half superiority, probably do just about deserve to edge it. But the French have been dangerous looking on the counter attack. Here's Pirlot, it's a good looking ball. Del Piero is offside though. Applauds the effort. He's changed his shirt, Donadoni. He was in a white number in the first half and he's gone for his nighttime looking blue. Vieira, who really has been good in midfield. I mentioned earlier that his club coach, Roberto Mancini, thinks he's injured and shouldn't be playing. And he's made a bit of a nonsense of that. He's had a fine game. Pirlot, man making the break on the right-hand side is Oddo. Pirlot finds him. Oddo rather forced back though by the presence of Abidal. And the crowd would like to see Oddo taking on the French players a little bit more, but every time he has tried, he's been outnumbered and shrugged off it. De Rossi was brought to ground, but the referee says play on. Ribéry with a clever dummy. Starts a counter-attack. Lost control of it though. He'll be doing very well if he gets it back off Cannavaro. Very few players do that. Buffon launching it downfield. Nice control from Makalele. Good turn as well away from Gattuso. Here's Ribéry. Gattuso's chasing back at him. Thierry Henry. Whistles from the crowd. They know he can do damage. Makalele with the shot. Oh dear. Well, he got the sand wedge out for that one, didn't he? Set up well by Henri and the chance opened up. Never going to be easy to beat Buffon from the edge of the box, but nevertheless, you'd expect a player of Makalele's ability to do better than that. That was a tired effort from Zambrotta, who stayed down. French carry on, as they have every right to do, of course. And he took a little bit of a knock as he stretched Zambrotta. Nothing malicious in it. Yeah. sure who the cameraman was trying to pick out there, to be honest. There's somebody worth picking out, Luca Toni. Chiellini, the Juventus left-back, sitting next to him. Chiellini, Italy's under-21 international captain for a couple of seasons, called into the senior squad for the first time in a while for this one, but missing out. Quarter of an hour remaining of normal time. And there's a player the Italian fans will not want to see come onto the field, David Trezeguet. Lethal goal scorer. Not half the player Thierry Henry is, but probably an even finer goal scorer, if truth be told. Henry has fouled his man. He came inside Oddo, but he couldn't beat Gattuso, who did very well to protect the ball with his body and forced Henry into the foul, really. De Rossi. Here's Oddo. And that again goes for the long cross. It's found its way halfway through the area, though. Well, in truth, it was fairly hit and hope from Oddo by the looks of things, but the French hesitated. Schroeder doing well in the end. Here's Pirlo. Oh dear. Oh dear, oh dear. Complete breakdown in communication between the two AC Milan teammates. Spectacular view of the stadium. Probably my favourite Italian stadium, in all honesty. I like the fact that the crowd are close to the pitch. I like the fact that the atmosphere that gets generated can really be sensed right around the ground. It's not true of most other Italian stadium. France on the counter-attack, though. The Italians wanted a free kick. Here's Henry. Three against four. Henry trying to trick his man. He goes into the area. Couldn't get enough purchase on the cross, though, and Buffon intercepted. And he's furious with his defence, Buffon. Think about it. Possession football, but the French defending very well. Every time the Italians take two steps forward, they're forced into a couple of steps back. Is Del Piero. De Rossi carries the ball forward. It's brought down. Probably a little bit lucky that he did get the free kick out of that situation, not before. Definitely a foul, but it didn't need to be a foul. De Rossi was heading down a blind alley, rather. And Italy will again fancy their chances with the last one that Pirlo took from the touchline. He overhit horribly. But any dead ball situation for the Italians is an opportunity because, generally speaking, this man delivers very well into the area. Lucarelli, Cannavaro, both strong in the air. De Rossi's not the tallest player either, the midfielder, but is strong aerially. Pirlo clips it in. Andro covers after the ball was flicked on and up. It's Lucarelli who actually managed to get a flick on, despite the fact that he was on the ground. Able to get enough accuracy on it though. Here's Malouda. Makaleli doing very well to find Malouda again. Ball runs away from him though. Vieira. Furiously done. Ribéry tricks Del Piero but goes backwards in doing so. Here's Malouda. Vidal on the overlap with the cross. It's a dangerous one as well, and the danger's not passed as Ribéry has retained possession for the French. Here's Diarra. Vieira. Keeps the ball moving. Italians defending well, it must be said. All the way back to Thuram on the halfway line. He goes long. Buffon comes for it and doesn't get it. And Cannavaro has to help his goalie out. Anelka, it was in there making a nuisance of himself. Goalie possibly took his eye off the ball as the big Frenchman went for it. Ribéry, the Italian fans getting nervous as the French start to play the ball around them. Gattuso, nicely done, Pirlo. Referee thought about giving the free kick, waves play on. Rightly so, advantage, Italy have the ball. Here's Del Piero. Oddo, Pirlo. Urging Italy forward a little bit quicker like they were at the start of the second half. The 1-2 doesn't come off. Malouda gets in there very quickly. Pirlo stays down. France play on. Pirlo is still down. There's no reason why France should stop, and Italy shouldn't stop either. Cannavaro intercepts. And now De Rossi puts the ball out of play. Third and final change for the Italians coming up. Di Natale, Udinese striker, about to come on. One would assume for Alex Del Piero. Similar player. Di Natale, the younger man, has an extra couple of yards of pace, though, which I think Donadoni will be looking to exploit. Del Piero, of course, crafty on the ball. Perfectly competent with the technical side of the game, but doesn't quite have the pace or the physical power to trouble these big, strong French defenders who are also extremely quick. Di Natale. Rumours were that he was going to be leaving Udinese during the summer, but he ended up staying. Udinese fans were looking forward to the partnership he would form with Fabio Quagliarella, signed from Sampdoria, but after a surprisingly good start in the opening game of the season, where they drew in here in the San Siro against Inter Milan, they got absolutely annihilated at home, 5-0 by newly promoted Napoli. So possibly going to be a tough opening section of the season for Di Natale. Well, Del Piero goes off. Mixture of cheers and whistles for Del Piero, who's always a controversial figure here in Milan. Played most of his career, of course, for arch-rivals Juventus. Di Natale on in his place for the last 7 minutes plus any injury time. Cannavaro getting enough on the ball to deflect it away to Massimo Oddo. It's probably being fouled in truth, but as Italy had the ball, the referee allowed it to continue. It's Di Natale's first touch. Gattuso. Thought about going wide to Massimo Oddo, elected against it. Malouda was covering it. Really haven't managed to get Oddo far enough down the flanks during this match. Been very well marshalled by Abidal. Christian Lucarelli. Ball is taken off him by Malouda, but taken out of play. Well, they've had Lucarelli on the field for a while now. They've not given him anything to try and get his head to. He's prodigiously good in the air, Lucarelli. Not the most subtle player you'll ever see. But again, rather guilty of overplaying it there, the Italians. Malouda steps away from his man. A substitution for the French, Toulin. About to come on, just being given some last minute instructions, although of course not by his coach, who's up in the stands. Very interesting to see here outfit at the moment. Italy are struggling to break them down after doing so a couple of times at the end of the first half and a couple of times at the beginning of the second half. The French have regained control defensively. Here's Rivelli, who has looked a very dangerous customer. De Rossi making a nuisance of himself with Makélélé. Makélélé was fouled by a combination of De Rossi and Gattuso. De Rossi and Perotta rather than Rome teammates. Well, De Rossi certainly was having a little kick away, and Perotta came in as well. De Rossi still complaining about it with the referee, but there was certainly a foul. Ribéry is coming off, which does surprise me a little bit. Probably been France's most effective attacking player. Possibly tiredness. Placed by Toulon, who's come on with some fresh instructions for his teammates. Time. Overall, I would suggest the result is probably the right one. Italy have shaded it, but haven't really done enough to win it. Are we in for a dramatic finale, however? Puts a little bit more pressure on Italy to go to the Ukraine and get a win on Wednesday night. Pirlo with the ball into the area. Lucarelli has slipped, though. Probably not wearing the right boots, Lucarelli. That's the second or third time he's slipped since coming on. Trying to change direction, losing his footing. Not noticed it be a problem for anyone else on the field. The crowd want Italy to come forward a little bit quicker than this. Though Italy would like the 3 points, but I'm not sure they're prepared to risk everything for it. Di Natale trying to go between two men, does it the second attempt, spreads it wide. That's good play from Di Natale. Lucarelli thought about the shot. Italy still on the attack. French have half smuggled the ball away, but Italy still have possession with Zambrotta. The noise from the crowd increases as the time ticks away, and Italy have time for a last couple of ditch attacks. Try and find a breakthrough. The cross from Odo is not a good one in truth. Here's Omri. That's poor play from Toulon, who's just come on. Might have been his first touch of the ball. His teammates won't thank him for that, giving the ball straight back to a blue shirt. Here's Di Natale. Nutmegs his man. Well, in truth, Di Natale probably could have easily gone round the outside of the French defender there. He was looking for the free kick and not looking to recover the ball. It's a good decision from the referee. Here's Zambrotta pacing away. Good crossing attempt. Diarra blocked it. I'm not sure what rhythm, in fairness, but doesn't matter. Of chest, arm, hand and face there from Chiara. Oh, and he slips. And the French break away. If Pananelka get there, no, he can't. Odda does very, very well. And he needed to. He was the last man as well, and Pananelka was off on goal. Donadoni telling his charges to calm down. It's Di Natale. Pirlo. Di Natale again, tackled, and tackled fairly by Diarra. Anywhere will do for France at the moment. Italy end the second half, as they started the second half, in the ascendancy. knocking the ball around well inside the French half and looking to create chances. But they've not managed to find a breakthrough. France have done a good, solid job. 3 minutes of added time. Here's Malouda. Is there to be a last twist in the tail? Henri, Malouda. Inside to Henri. Overhit it. Souza comes away. Pirlo. There's De Rossi. Now the French left it late in the final of Euro 2000. Is there to be a late dramatic winner in this one? Here's Di Natale. Slings it into the area. It's a good-looking cross as well. Makélélé did well. Gattuso stayed down. Italy carry on, though. Here's Oddo. Oh, dear, oh, dear. The occasion got to him. And he wasted the crossing opportunity. And that might be Italy's last significant attacking moment. A minute and a half remaining of the three to be added on, and France have possession. And at times in this game, they've looked very comfortable and confident in possession and have kept the ball well. Here's Malouda buying time, and he's bought some time. Perotta with a rather clumsy challenge. Well, there was no need for that from Perotta. Malouda was outnumbered 3-1. Highly unlikely he was going to go anywhere. And it gives the French opportunity to eat up a few more seconds. And there's a sign of their intent, perhaps understandably so. Over the two games with Italy in these qualifiers, they've won, really. 3-1 victory in Paris, 0-0 draw here. If they can see off Scotland on Wednesday night at home, that would be a massive step towards qualification. As their next two games following that, although both away, or one away, is to the Faroe Islands and at home to Lithuania, and you would expect them to win both of those. So this draw could be a really big step towards qualification. Italy, however, realistically, will have to go to the Ukraine on Wednesday night and get the win. Italy perhaps on the balance of play marginally the better side, but France did enough defensively and looked dangerous on the counter attack. Pippo Inzaghi came closest, his cross shot clipping the top of the bar. Del Piero had a good chance which he wasted, spurning it at the near post, but Ribéry almost carved Italy open a couple of times for what would have been a priceless goal for the French. A number of these players, of course, huge world stars. We'll be seeing them in action over the course of the coming Champions League. But will we be seeing all of them in action in Euro 2008? Well, France have taken the bigger of the two steps tonight. They play Scotland at home on Wednesday. Italy have a very tough game away to the Ukraine. Donadoni probably disappointed with the result ultimately, as his side did more of the attacking. But here in Milan's San Siro Stadium, it is finished. Italy 0, France 0.
Douglas Dean, your commentator, and a nil or draw. So, well, that means just 2 points separate the top three in this section, Group B, that is France, Scotland and Italy. There it is. And alongside me to discuss the outcome of today's results, Craig Foster and Paul Ocon. So France still on top, a very good point for them, Paul, in Milan.
I think it was important that they didn't lose France for their qualification. A win tonight would have more or less sealed it, but I think they'll be quite confident that on Wednesday in Paris, they'll knock off Scotland and qualify.
Craig, what about for you? How is this group shaping up now?
France is still look. It's a good point for them. I guess for Italy, at least they didn't lose. Then they would have been in a lot of trouble. It would have been a much greater result for France. But the winner this morning, Scotland, it keeps them right in the hunt there. Their win this morning against Lithuania was great, a fantastic result for them. The key match now, as Paul was saying, looms, which is in Scotland. Italy against Scotland there in front of the Scottish fans, who are brilliant. So it looks likely to come down to that match, which is going to be a lot of pressure on the Italians, and particularly on Donadoni. I thought the second half, first half was good. It was nice and balanced. Both teams had good periods in there. There were some chances. Second half was rubbish, basically. It was very disappointing with France this morning. Okay, you're away from home, you want a point, but some of their play, at least Italians were playing beautifully through midfield all the time, whereas France just it's a long time since I've seen them so happy to just hoof the ball from back to front. I'm sure Dominic will get criticised after that. They'll be pleased, obviously, with the point, but I'm sure the way they play, particularly in the second half, I don't think the French would be too happy with that.
Paul, how do you think the Italian press, since you know them so well from your playing days at Lazio and Fiorentina, will respond to this result now when Donadoni's future? Just keep working, chipping away?
I think he'll come under even more pressure. Of course, Wednesday's game in the Ukraine is I wouldn't say a must win, but it's a very, very important game. And if the Italians don't get a good result there, then I think he might be shown the door. But like Fozzie said, I think the Italians tried to play a little bit more. Maybe that might have been because they were the home team. But I am still disappointed in them. I still think that towards the end there, they lacked ideas and, from wide areas were just knocking hopeful balls into the box, which, they didn't look dangerous at all.
Well, it's a point you raised, Craig, at halftime, wasn't it? Yeah. The lack of creativity for Italy. We'll have a look at some of the key highlights from the second half and just tell me, Craig, what is, I guess, the problem for Italian football? They're the world champions. Is there a problem? I mean, because they look so well organised.
Well, they are. They're the hardest team to break down in world football, and in World Cups, that makes a huge difference. But, you've got Camoranesi and Del Piero, who's past his best, so they don't have tremendous width, they don't have tremendous speed out wide, which a lot of the best teams in the world now do have. And they just lack a player. You know, when you're going to play De Rossi, for me, and also Gattuso alongside Pirlo, you've got one great player in Pirlo, but you've got two real sort of workers, really. De Rossi's a little bit more classy, but you've got two workers there with one quality guy, but then sitting in behind the striker, there's no one there who's going to provide you with this element of creativity, which you've got two absolute top class teams, both tactically and technically, there on the park, and it's the different players who often make the difference. And at the moment for Italy, with Totti out, you can't really see where it's going to come from.
Craig? And Paul, rather, what about for you? These two teams, they would be the favourites in a lot of tournaments, but how do you think they're shaping up? France now, in particular, leading the group. What do you think they've got to look forward to as they try to qualify?
Well, they're definitely missing a player like Zidane, and everybody knows it's difficult to replace somebody like Zidane in such a short space of time since the World Cup. Mm. But I, like Fozzie, very, very disappointed in their play. I expected a lot more from them. But of course, at the end of the day, it's the result that is the most important, and I'd say they got probably the favourable result, between the two teams.
Speaking of results, let's run through them for you now, because so many matches being played, 20 in all, on the road to Euro 2008, and Scotland beat Lithuania, as you heard, 3-1. Ukraine dropping points away to Georgia, and there were goals from Sean Wright-Phillips, Michael Owen and Micah Richards guiding England to that crucial win over Israel. Russia now leads that section where England is following a solid win over Macedonia. Romania beat Belarus away, and Northern Ireland have slumped to a surprise defeat in Latvia. Iceland have a surprise lead, by the way, over Spain at halftime, and Spain down to 10 men following the dismissal of Xabi Alonso after 20 minutes. Emil Halvorsen with the goal there, and Xabi Alonso, as I said, sent off, so really difficult now for the Spaniards. But Tomasz Rosicki was among the goals in San Marino, so too Marek Jankulovski and Jan Koller. Croatia took the points against Estonia. Eduardo da Silva, the Arsenal striker, with a double there. The Republic of Ireland's hopes of qualification have suffered a major blow, with Slovakia claiming a last-minute equaliser. Holland beat Bulgaria thanks to the Real Madrid pair of Wesley Sneijder and Ruud van Nistelrooy, and former Tottenham striker Stefan Iversen has given Norway the points in Moldova. A Miroslav Klose double in Cardiff gave Germany a comfortable win, and Malta have produced one of the real surprise results today in a 2-2 draw with Turkey. And here's some of the action now from Wembley. England against Israel. Let's not forget England with so many issues up front. The absence of Wayne Rooney, Peter Crouch not there today either. And then they step up and get a great result under serious pressure, Craig, you have to say. 3-0. I mean, they did it in style as well.
Yeah, Israel have, you know, when they were over in Israel for that game, Israel were really poor, actually. They showed no real initiative to go forward, and they're just playing for a result at home. Away from home, I always thought England were capable of getting it. But this is a huge morale booster, you know, particularly for McLaren, who's been under immense pressure. Had they have only got a draw or not played well in this game, then he would have been, you can imagine, the press in the next week. So for him, that really, I think the dogs are off for a while, and it's a very, very good result for them.
Croatia leading that group ahead of Russia, and it's really going to come down to the wire, it seems, there as well, Paul, when you look at Russia's got England coming up.
I was confident that England were going to win tonight. It would have been very difficult for them to fail at Wembley in front of 80,000 people. But they've got a very, very important match also on Wednesday night. But it's a home game, so with that win, I think they'll take a lot of confidence into the game. I think they're looking at second spot rather than the top spot.
All right, boys, we're all done. Thanks a lot, Paul.
Gents.
Good to see you. Craig, you go home and get some rest because you've got the World Game later today.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. See you there.
All right, Paul, we'll catch up again soon. Thank you. So that's all we have time for this morning, but, of course, plenty to come here on SBS in September. Yes, a massive month of football continues on SBS starting this afternoon with highlights of the FIFA World Under-17 semi-finals from 3:30 p.m. with the full 90 minutes of the final from 10 p.m. tonight. The World Game returns this afternoon with all the latest action from the A-League, a full wrap of Euro 2008 action and preview of the Socceroos big clash with Argentina with Josip Skoko. And you can see the action from the Olyroos' tremendous win over North Korea last night as well. Don't forget the Matildas kick off their FIFA Women's World Cup campaign against Ghana on Wednesday the 12th, exclusively live here on SBS. And before, of course, the world's best competition returns on September 19. It's the UEFA Champions League, it's back on SBS, and it's double helpings this season with the holders AC Milan kicking off our coverage at 4:45 a.m. followed by a full replay of the action from the Bernabeu as Real take on Bremen. And on the 20th, we'll be live from the Nou Camp and also head to the Emirates Stadium for Sevilla's Champions League debut. And don't forget, for all your football needs, just go to our website, sbs.com.au, and follow the links to the World Games site. So all square, it finished today in Milan. France top of the group, and Italy still in a mighty battle to qualify for Euro 2008. I'm Andrew Orsatti from the team. It's goodbye.